Hey guys, it's Ileane from basicblogtips.com, and today we're going to continue our series about getting more views on YouTube using annotations. If you didn't see the first video, we talked about in-video programming. Now today we're going to get into putting annotations on individual videos. There's a few benefits of adding annotations to videos, so let's go over those real quickly. One would be to get more subscribers on your channel. The other would be to get people to watch more of your videos. You know, YouTube likes when we keep people on YouTube. So if you have videos that are related, you want to get people to check out the other videos on your channel. And more importantly for bloggers and website owners, we want to get people to come back to our website. So let's see how we can set up annotations to do those three things. Go into your video manager. And next to each one of your videos, you'll see edit. And you can add your annotations that way. Another way we can access the annotations is right from the watch page of a specific video. And the annotations are indicated by this little icon right here. Here's an example of an annotation that I set up on this video. I put an overlay of the cover of this YouTube report I did. And when people click that link, they go to a page where I have a sign up form for people to get the report and sign up for my email list. And come to think of it, by the way, if you want that report, just go to basicblogtips.com/getYouTubeReport. Now let's go into YouTube and set up an annotation. The annotations interface is pretty simple. You come over here if you want to add an annotation. Here's the different options you have: speech bubble, note, title, spotlight, and label. Now most of the time you're going to want to use one of these that will link back to something. So I recommend the spotlight or the note. But you can experiment with all these to see which ones work best with your video and your content. So let's keep it simple and add a note. Now, what you'll see here is the timeline, and this is the indication from where you want to place the annotation in the video. Now, keep in mind, as I showed you in the previous video about in-video programming, you don't want to have too many calls to action at one specific spot in the video. So since I know that my in-video programming is in the last 30 seconds of the video, then I want to keep any other annotations towards the beginning or the middle of the video. So you'll type in your message. You have a choice of four different font sizes. The color of the text. And I would always just try to make it contrasting. It could be black or white, but remember to not use black text on a black background or white on a white. So use any of these other contrasting colors that will make the annotation stand out. Then once you've done that, this is where you get the choice to link to a video, one of your video playlists, that's also an excellent idea, your YouTube channel. You can also link to your Google Plus profile. Get people to subscribe to your channel. If you have a fundraising project or an associated website, and also merchandise. In this case, we're going to link to an associated website, and just so you know, the association has to be set up in your YouTube settings before you can use your website link. In my case, I already have my blog, Basic Blog Tips, set up as my associated website. Real quickly, in order to get that associated website, just go into your channel settings under the Advanced tab. associated websites right here. You add in your name of your website, and then you'll get success. It'll give you an option to approve that. Now, once you've had annotations in place on a few videos, give it a few weeks and then come over to your analytics. Go down to annotations. Of course, this is in beta. And see how your annotations are performing. The ones that are doing well for you, like I mentioned before, the spotlight and the notes do well for me. So therefore, I go back and I add more of those. But you just continue to test until you find out the ones that are helping you reach your goals. That's it for today, and I want to see you succeed on YouTube. Please subscribe to my channel and keep following me for all these tips. I have lots of them on my website as well, and I'll see you in the next video.